Hi. Let's go to the Relay Protection tab. Distance Protection. Choose to add an element. This is the distance protection for ABB devices. This is for Siemens devices. This is a block for the MHO characteristics of the distance relay included in one of the most common relay protection kits in the ex-USSR territory, EPZ 1636. DZ2 is a switchable relay with two zones. KRS is a separate relay for the third zone with more customizable settings. Both relays are normally connected to line voltages and currents and are designed to interrupt face-to-face short circuits. You can use our block to analyze any other distance relay with the same connection and setting. For example, a BRE series relay. This tab adds a short circuit impedance calculation. Here you can add zones. In this window, write the setting for the zone reach. The slope angle of the characteristic. Offset in percent. Eccentricity. Direction. Color. I'll start filling in the settings that will be used in the example. I change the grid spacing. Color. Please note that if you set the offset to 100%, then you get a circle with a center at the origin. Let's change the eccentricity. Direction. I fill in the rest of the zones. In this example, I have two 110 kV parallel lines and file from this side. The same protections are installed on the lines, high-speed protections are taken out of operation due to a malfunction. The lines are protected only by backup protections which are EPZ 1636. First line voltage. Second. Currents of the first line. Second. I've hid all channels from other feeders so they don't get in the way. As you can see, there was a complete shutdown of the substation. The voltages show a decrease in phase A and B. You can see an increase in current on phase A. Then on phase B. And then on both phases A and B. Let's look at the currents of the second line. Now I will calculate the zero sequence currents for both lines. As you can see, at first a short circuit was with earth, then without. Now we can divide the event into three sections. The first section lasts until one of the lines is tripped from the power side. The second section with a single phase short circuit on another phase. In the third section, we see a two-phase short circuit without earth. There is no zero sequence current here. Let's look at the vector diagram. I add the zero sequence voltage measured by the voltage transformer and the calculated channels. I choose the zero sequence voltage as the base channel. It can be seen that the zero sequence power was first directed to the second line at all, and only after disconnection from the power end, the zero sequence power began to be directed to the first line. Now let's add distance protection characteristics. I turn off the vector diagram. Linking comtrade file channels and a short circuit impedance calculator for the first line. I forgot to select the fault loop. Now it shows impedance vectors. Before fault vectors looking in the reverse direction. Also in the first section. And only here they move to the first quadrant. Impedance in the third zone. Wow, he's out of bounds here. And here again in the third zone. This zone time is 4.2 seconds. It did not have time to work and the trip occurred on the other side. I'll try to link the currents of the second line with the calculator. Here one of the vectors in the first section falls into the first quadrant, but it's out of boundaries. And from the second section until the end of the fault, power is transmitted along the line towards the substation from which we received the comtrade file. To summarize. In this case, we have a complex short circuit that goes from one type to another. The zero sequence current protections as part of the EPZ1636 protection kit did not have time to work. The zero sequence current has stopped. The protections designed to eliminate phase-to-phase short circuits also did not have time to work, and a trip occurred at the power substation, as a result of which half of the city was left without electricity. Thank you for watching. Peace for everyone.